Must not have been paying attention. Whoa. What my girl say? I got love all over me. Maybe a touch every part of me. Ooh, I got love all over me. Bitch, I'm not even in love, honey. I just felt like singing.
I get all that myself, and I feel like that is a very important thing when a woman is independent.
My mouth's a moist, and the liquid is just going everywhere.
That's trigger points. Everybody has trigger points. Let's just be honest. Those are my trigger points.
Yoplait yogurt is like. I hit every single option possible. Baby, I did like baking. I think if you. Even though that's just a label, we're trans women, but we're still human at the end of the day. We want what everybody else wants, and that's just to be loved and accepted. That's all we damn want. Yes. Love and acceptance.
This is what we're going to do because I feel that I'm getting out of my character. So, this is what we're going to do.
It's half your life, isn't it? Mine, we came a long way.
Hey guys, be sure to subscribe. It's free to subscribe. We support who we want to support. So I want you all to support me, but I want you all to want to support me. That's the thing. And I want you to just support me because the bitch saying support. I want you to actually want to support me. It's fucking hot up in here. I'm turning the heat off. Be sure to subscribe, like, share, comment, tell a friend who's going to tell another friend who's going to tell another friend who just so happens to be a whore, right? If you've been watching my recent videos, I've been, you know, talking about my situations with these men. Because I talk a lot of, I have to be honest, I talk a lot of noise. And I joke a lot, but trust me, when it's time to be serious, it's time to be serious. And no one knows you better than you. And I personally feel, hold on, baby, because we gotta, excuse me, it's warm up in here, child. It's a little too warm, baby. Woo. I'm about to be falling off the bone in a minute. Shit, they got me in the oven. Okay. What was I saying? Oh, Lord, thank you, Jesus. Let the air up in here. Let the air flow. Let it snow. Back to the topic. No one knows you better than you. Or no one should know you better than you. How can I say this without trying to sound conceited? I am very obsessed with myself, right? And by me being obsessed with myself, I pay attention to a lot about me. A lot of things I admire, I love, and I adore about myself. But there are certain things that I don't too much care for. But it's who I am. So I feel that it is my duty and my job when I see something I'm not too fond of about myself, it is my duty and my job to make the proper changes, right? Or attempt to change it. Shit, I'm trying. My biggest struggle, child, this is like a broken record, but my biggest struggle is men, you know? And don't get me wrong, I'm very independent. If you don't know, let me help you understand, baby. One thing about Maya Ray, she is very independent. I'm very independent. I don't ever need a man. I would like one, though. I said it before. Shit, this ain't breaking news. I would like one. But, you know, with me being the type of woman I am, I don't know. I'm not trying to sound like I broke my nail, y'all. Don't ever go to the nail salon and admit, fuck them. But I don't know if I would ever find the type of man that I need. Not saying that it never will happen, but it does feel like it, if I'm being honest. Because for the record, getting penis is never a problem. It's just getting a man, a worthy man. Because I do like a certain type of man. I like a masculine man. But overall, I like an honest man. Over everything, I like an honest man. And I don't know if I shared this with you all before, but my ex, one of my exes, told me one of the most hurtful things I am still dealing with to this day. How he told me that I have a great personality. He's never met someone like me. True, true, true. But he doesn't see himself with me. I don't want to lie to me. He doesn't see himself with me because I'm trans. And he can't picture himself giving me what I deserve. And I can't help but to respect that about him. I respect that because he sees my worth. He knows that I deserve to be treated like a motherfucking trophy. And he was aware that he wasn't the person to give it to me. I can respect that part. But what I cannot respect about that was although he was not willing to give me the pedestal I feel I know I deserve from a man. I do deserve to be treated like a queen on a pedestal from a man. I feel like that. I feel like all women should feel like that, okay? All women who want a man should feel like a man should put their man should put them on a pedestal. I do not respect how he knew that he wasn't willing to give me that. However, he was also not willing to release me out of the cage and let me fly and be free. Honey, I had to break out. I had to break out the motherfucking cage. Honey, you can't keep the phoenix in the cage because she rises from the ashes. The same ashes they tried to kill me with. Hello, catch that. Yes. But I brought that up because a more recent situation happened that reminded me of that same exact environment. I went by a gentleman, handsome guy. You know how Maya do, honey. He was very handsome. And we were talking. And see, this is the thing. Intimacy is intimacy is more powerful than sex. You get what I'm saying to you? Intimacy is when you can sit next to a person and just let your guard down. And you're pouring into one another. You're absorbing energy. You're creating memories. You're creating moments with this person. Intimacy to me is some powerful shit, baby. Ooh, it's deep. So me and this gentleman, we were being intimate with one another. We were talking about each other's upbringing and childhood. And he told me, just our conversation, we only met one time. And I end up, you know, I always tell you, I don't ever spend a night by a man's house. But I end up staying by his house because that's how comfortable I felt. I felt very comfortable to spend a night by his house. But he opened up to me as I opened up to him about our upbringing. And he shared with me how one of his brothers found, this was when he was a teenager, I believe, y'all. One of his brothers came behind him on the family's laptop and seen that he was looking at transgender porn, trans porn, you know, on the porn site, and said that his brother, instead of exposing or, you know, trying to shame him publicly, he shamed him privately, because his brother called him into the room and began to be physical with him, start punching him and kicking him. And as he was telling me the story, you can see the pain in his eyes and the shame that has been instilled in him from such a young age, because he always said he was interested in the same sex, and he was just interested in femininity, you know. By, you know, back in the day, child, we didn't, so he's from the country too, we didn't too much know what trans was. We didn't know what that was. So at the time, it was just a flamboyant guy, and, you know, he was always interested in stuff like that. You know, I'm trying to not sound like I want to be offensive to anyone. And he said something that we all know. Although the beating was hurtful, and it was it was supposed to be a lesson to teach him that what he's doing is wrong, the feeling that he had towards the same sex and or trans people and trans women, I'm sorry, no or, it never went away. It never went away. But the shame, instead of him being taught that, instead of them trying to make him not be who he was, they just instilled him to be ashamed to be who he was. And that's one of the biggest problems in the Black community. It brought so much pain to my heart. I felt so sorry. I just looked him in his eyes and I said, I'm so sorry you had to go through that. You can see the pain. You can see the pain in his face. And I hate that. You know, he's like a real, you know, you can tell, that, let me say this. He has been through a lot, and he is full of so much pain. You know, it's harvesting itself into aggression, because he comes off very rude and mean. But when you sit down and let him talk, he's just hurt. He's just someone who wants to be accepted. That's why I say this life is not easy. It's not easy for a trans woman, and it's damn sure not easy for a Black trans attracted man. But anyway, I say all that because it just something about him treating me just normal. See, that's my weak spot. I just want to be treated normal. You know, I said it in my intro. We all just want to be loved and accepted. That's all we damn want. And I stand by that. That's some powerful shit. But I say that because it's a painful feeling to know that you are worth the moon and the stars. And other people see your worth, but they're just not willing to give you what you are worth. That is some powerful, backhanded, complimentary shit. Because I feel that I'm worth it all. I do. But it's a different feeling, y'all, when other people confirm that you are worth so much, but they are just not willing to give you that. That's a hurtful feeling, y'all. And I got some thick skin, tender skin, but thick. And as much as I tell you all to not put your feelings involved, get your feelings involved with these men, I want you all to stand by that, because I'm standing by that. But at the same time, it does make you feel, because I'm human. It makes you feel a certain type of way to know that there's a strong possibility I may not get to experience a man accepting me as the figure that holds his heart. That's deep, ain't it? There's a strong possibility, never say never, y'all, but there's a strong possibility that I may never get to experience a man realizing and accepting me as the love of his life. Publicly. Publicly. And I don't know how to feel about that, if I'm being honest. I don't know. I know it hurts. It hurts. Sometimes it hurts like hell. That's Aretha Franklin. But yeah. But you know, I look in the mirror and it does bring some type of joy to know that there's nothing wrong with me. Despite what they try to instill in me growing up into this day, there ain't a damn thing wrong with me. Ain't nothing wrong with Maya. It's the world and society we live in. And as much as I get on here and I tell y'all about my little nighttime adventures I have, I'm still holding on because I'm a hopeless romantic. You know, I be dibbling, dabbling, honey. I love to have some fun. Girls just want to have fun. But at heart, in my heart, I have always been and probably always will be a hopeless romantic. So I pray and I hope and I wish I at least get to experience true love. Girl, I don't know if it's because the time change just got me feeling all butterfly-ish. But I want to experience true love. Child, I had some relationships. I got some relationships under my belt. Child. And they ain't nothing to brag about. Look, I'm sitting here thinking about them. They ain't nothing to brag about. Nothing to brag about. And I tell y'all this all the time. There's one relationship that I'm still at. Out of all my exes, there's only one that has actually turned out to be a wonderful friendship. What else you say? We ain't good, but we still good. And that's Jules. Shout out to you, Jules. Hello. Yeah, Jules. We're still good friends. We're still friends on social media. We still talk. So everything don't have to end bad, y'all. So I do got that. But yeah, I want to experience real love. I do. Oh, I do. Just the thought of it. But I also had to have that conversation with myself. Maya, you a black trans in America, in the South. It's a possibility you might not experience it. And I'm okay with that. Let me tell you something. Yeah, I broke my... I'm telling you, I don't go to that place and they ate me to get your nails done. I would love to experience love. True love. But at the same time, I'm okay if I don't. Because like I said, I'm in a different type of lifestyle. I'm a trans woman. So I see the people when they be in relationships and all that type of stuff. And they seem happy. But those men are not being who they truly are. Because like the guy I told y'all about earlier, with his brother getting physical with him, he has children. And he's not even attracted to biological women. He had children because he was trained that's what he's supposed to do, be a man and multiply. He's a black guy from Mississippi. Okay? In the black community, you can be anything in this world as a black man, as a black person, as a black male in the family, in the black community. You can be anything in this world but gay and trans attracted. You can't be that. And that's a problem I can't fix. I wish I could. It ain't gonna change, y'all. No time soon. I hate that about my community. My community. You can be anything but gay if you're a man. If you're a man, you can be anything but gay. And if you are gay, don't be no fucking trans. And don't be no flamboyant gay. They hate it. Ooh, they hate it. They fucking hate it. And it's so sad. It's so sad. And it's life is hard. Life is already hard for the average person. Try being a black trans woman and tell me how hard life is. So, yeah, I do want to experience true love, but at the same time, it's scary. Because I already experience a man's reality, which is he wants to be with a trans. He wants to be with a trans or a man, but he's too conditioned to do it only at nighttime and only to sneak around and do it because he'll never have the guts and the bravery to be himself. It's a lot to unpack, y'all, in the black community, especially when it comes down to gays and trans. It's a lot. Like, and he's just one guy. I'm sure the stuff he was telling me, none of that's new. I'm sure it's been going on and still going on in the black community. I see it all. I see it way too much. Hell, the kids and shit, they're grooming their sons to be thugs and all this because they're trying to over-masculinate their sons because they'd rather have a son out there in the streets making all these babies that they don't want than to have a son bring home a man or a trans that they really do want. I don't know what else to say. Somebody real hard to find. Okay, I'm about to get ready. My auntie passed away. One of my favorite aunties, because family, you can't choose family. You can't choose your family. And if you've been following me, y'all know one thing about me. I am a open book and I'm a straight shooter. I call it like it is. Right or wrong, bitch, I'm gonna speak how I feel. My auntie Gert passed away, and she was one of the few aunties that I respect, I love, and I adore. And this might sound selfish, but I'm going to be honest. I respect, I love, and I adore that lady because she respect and love and adore me. I've always been like that. I am a reciprocation. Is it reciprocation? When you a reflection, whatever it is, bitch, I don't know. Fuck, I'm not thinking right now. I'm a mirror, let's say that. I show you what you show me. My auntie Gert, bless her heart, she's always shown me acceptance and love. She know damn well my mama and her brother Frank didn't name me no Maya Ray. Maya. She know my name. But guess what? She always called me that. She will correct herself and call me her niece. She complimented my appearance every time. I can be looking a mess. She still tell me I'm beautiful. I love her. I always say I love who love me. I stand by that. That lady has always been respectful towards me. So I have to go to her funeral Saturday. Oh, I love her so much. And she was an elder lady in her 70s. She's from a whole different generation. Yet, she loved and respected her trans niece. That is what you call love. Yeah, that's what you call love. And my cousin, her daughter, reached out earlier and said we had to wear yellow. Not mandatory, but you know. But we have to wear yellow. I'm assuming it's her favorite color. So I'm going to have to come on through and bring a little sunshine up in there. For my auntie, of course. Bring a little sunshine. Hey, on a cloudy day. Clock me, I'm about to work. I guess you say, what make a man feel this way? Maya, 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 talking about Maya Ray. Ooh. Doom, 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 doom. All right, I'm gone, y'all. I'm gone. That was deep when I was talking about earlier, chat. It's deep. Damn, this life is really not for the weak. Seriously. Yeah.